Hold your peace. Okay, so there's our crew. We'll introduce ourselves on the podcast. I think what we'll do today, guys, is kind of Eric, you'll have the last word before as we get started. But I'll ask everybody just to kind of give me their quick headline. Hanson, what are you doing?
Oh, sorry. I'm responding to people on Twitter who are upset at me.
Yeah, I'm going to be one of them.
Because of my hysterics yesterday.
Oh, my God. So anyway, when we do the podcast, everybody just sort of give me your headline. Give me your 15-second summary of what's foremost on your mind about this. And then we'll kind of dive into what happened. I think this podcast is just going to be about the election. And we'll do local, state, and national, I think, in that order. Hanson was walking around the station yesterday. He comes into my office around six. What, it was before your show, right?
Before my show, 5:30.
5:30. And he goes, well, Cook County isn't voting. In Chicago, the vote numbers are down from the list. And he's had all these metrics. And he was just, we had to talk him off a ledge.
I was just reading numbers, John.
And then you were kind of like flowering the offices with your doom. You were just bumping into people going, you know, the world's going to win. Bye now, got to run. And that was what you were doing. It put a knot in my stomach.
Well, it didn't last very long, John. So, you know, I just like to shake things up, you know, make sure people are on their feet. They're thinking about things. They're looking at the numbers.
I had the same fear, but I wasn't sowing it like that. I was
exactly.
I think I was trying to convince my own brain to get to the point of doom so that it all felt better after that.
Well, that's kind of, I think, where a lot of us were anyway. You thought, all right, this is going to be a hard night. And I wasn't even going to watch. And then my son was looking at it and it didn't look so bad. You know, it didn't look like this huge red wave. So I thought, oh, all right, I'll watch a little bit of it. And then you get sucked in to that sort of coverage, you know.
I was right a week ago. I don't know why I changed my mind.
What was that?
I felt good a week ago. I felt like it was going to not be a red wave a week ago. But then I lost all credibility 2 hours before the polls closed.
Well, I think everybody had reason to be happy and reason to be discouraged by things that happened yesterday.
Wait a minute. Everybody had reason to be happy? What are you talking about? Well, we can talk about this when we get it rolling. Yeah. But I think we should do state. We can do the Evanston ranked choice voting.
Yeah, how about that?
You're an Evanstonian, aren't you, Mark?
Yes, I am.
Like 82% in favor of ranked choice voting. I thought that was really interesting.
Which would tell us right now who the winner in Georgia was. I mean, we could know right now. We didn't have to have a runoff.
That's right. Yeah, think of all the money and the, you know, the angst and everything else. I mean, there's a lot of reasons why ranked choice voting is a good idea.
Okay, well, let's get started. Pardon me, I'm just sipping on my soda and thinking about it. It's my notes. So we'll go, John, you introduce yourself first. Mark, say what you want to say about who you are, what you are, why you are. You selling a book, anything like that? No. Apples on the corner, whatever. No. Then Eric. So me, John, Mark, and Eric. And too bad the other guys can't join us today because I think we got a lot of ground to cover.